When we talk about creativity, when we talk about art, when we talk about all these things, and you know, I'm kind of on this, forgive me for beating the same drum, I just need to beat it for a little bit. When we talk about this stuff, instantly, as soon as we start talking about creativity, we start talking about art, a percentage of us in the room automatically check out. Because we have been told that we are not creative. We have been told, oh, your right mind or left brain or whatever that thing is. And we've been told that for whatever reason. Now, there is some science behind it that is somewhat true. But instead of it actually helping you to understand that you are creative, it's actually held you back. It's fascinating to me that every child is creative. Every child. I've yet to meet a child that's not creative. What I mean by that, they just express however they want to express, whether it's with some object, whether it's with a pen, whether it's with their voice, whether it's with their body, it doesn't matter, whatever it is, every child expresses themselves, they're free because they know that they were born to be creative. But somehow in the progression of life, we begin to tell people, oh, you're not creative, okay, and things begin to happen, and pretty soon we have a small percentage of society that we tell, oh, those are the creative ones. Obviously they are, but I'm concerned that we have offloaded a responsibility and we put it on someone else, not realizing that you are the only one on the face of the earth and all of time that can express a certain facet of God. God is so multidimensional, he needs all of humanity's help. He's got so much going on that he's like, I need a lot of billions of people to express who I am. So whenever I talk about creativity, I understand there are people that seem to be more gifted, and I think it's true. I think there are elements of truth to that. But I will not buy into the idea that there is creative ones and then there's the non-creative ones. No, we've got to understand, I don't know about you, but you may not be good at the paintbrush or a song or anything that we typically put in this category of creativity, but you might have the most beautiful mind when it comes to numbers. I've met business guys that say they're not creative, and I hear how they run their business. I'm like, you're extremely creative. It's in a different expression. It's with spreadsheets and numbers and structures and flows and product flows and manufactured. I'm like, I could not even attempt to do that if I tried. But it's so easy to them. What is that? It's their gifting. It's expressing themselves in numbers and product, et cetera, et cetera. It's just not a painting. But it's amazing that God gave you the capacity to come up with ideas to bring life. You know what I'm really fascinated with? I'm just going to tell you what I'm fascinated with. That's what tonight's all about. I'm fascinated with that you can actually write a book. You can put thought on the page or on the screen, however you write. You can put thought on a piece of paper. You package it in a nice little book, and you multiply it by thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, and people read it all over the world, and they get touched. And you wrote that book in your living room, and 2 years later, someone's reading it, and they get touched with the power of God. Isn't that fascinating? That you could put something on paper that has a time-release capsule to it. You can record a song. You can record a worship setting. You can record anything, put it onto a CD or an MP3, and someone can download it on the other side of the world, and they receive the anointing. They get touched by God. What's happening? It somehow got exported, and it still has life on it. There are others that come up with incredible business models, and it works in your business, and you actually give it to someone else, and they do it, and it continues to produce life. So we have to kind of break down what's creative, or are there creative people? I'm already stating my case on that. What I want to do is I want to get every single person in this room and anyone that's listening to realize I am creative, my job to find out what it looks like. That's what I want you to do. If I give you any homework, it's that. Stop telling yourself, I'm not creative. I just don't. No. Find out what it looks like, because you have the ability, the capacity to think, to imagine, to come up with ideas that when you express it right, the life of God is all over it.